स्टूडेंट टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डू क्लास फिफ्थ सब्जेक्ट सोशल स्टडी चैप्टर सिक्स दैट इज आवर गवर्नमेंट सो लेट्स स्टार्ट स्टूडेंट बाय रीडिंग आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट आल्सो सो स्टार्ट द डेमोक्रेटिक फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इज वन विच हैज कलेक्टिव सेशन बिहाइंड इट इट इज अ गवर्नमेंट of the people, by the people, and for the people. A democratic government is a government in which the citizens have the right to participate in the governing process and in making important decisions for the welfare of the whole society. A democratic government must fulfill its responsibility toward the citizen. India became independent on 15th August 1947 and its constitution was adopted on 26 January 1950. According to the Constitution of India, India is a union state. It has a vast country with 29 states and 7 union territories. A single government cannot govern a big country like India. So the government has a form at two levels, one at the central level and the other at the state level. Power have been distributed between both the levels in order to avoid conflict. Conflict means a serious disagreement and argument over an idea or a belief. During any crisis, the central government comes to the aid of the state government. A central government or the union government consists of the president, vice president, and a council of ministers headed by the prime minister. The body that makes laws. It is called the parliament and it has two houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Let's study in detail about the two houses. The first house is Lok Sabha, that is it are called as lower house. The Lok Sabha consists of 545 members, out of which 543 members are elected directly by the people. Two members may be nominated by the president from the Anglo-India, by the president from Anglo-India community. If it is not adequately represented in the Lok Sabha, citizens who are 18 years and above can vote and elect their representatives. These representatives are nominated by various parties. As many citizens above the age of 25 can stand for election to the Lok Sabha. Next house is Rajya Sabha or the upper house. The Rajya Sabha at present has 245 seats. Members of Rajya Sabha are elected for 6 years. 12 members are nominated by the president. Rest of them are elected by the members of Legislative Assembly. These members of Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha are called member of parliament. The member of parliament and the state legislative assembly elect the president of India. The president is the head of state. The prime minister is the leader of political party which has majority in the Lok Sabha. He is the most powerful minister and the real head of the country government. The prime minister chooses minister of different department like home, defense, agriculture, etc. A council of minister is formed and it is responsible to the parliament. Next is state government. After central government, the next government is state government. Every state has its own government at the state level also. The elected representative of the people make law and runs the government. The elected member became a member of the state legislative assembly. They are called the member of legislative assembly. That is MLA. They are elected for a 5-year term. The governor, who is the highest authority in the state, is appointed by the president. He appoints the leader of the majority party in the legislative assembly as a chief minister. The chief minister selects its council of ministers. Next is judiciary. There are district court. In a district to resolve the dispute between people. The High Court is the highest court in the state. The Supreme Court is in New Delhi, the highest court in the country. Its decision are final. This is the Supreme Court of the India. It is situated in New Delhi. This is the Chennai High Court, which is situated in Chennai, that is Tamil Nadu. The Chief Justice is the head of the Supreme Court. He is appointed by the President. Next is responsibilities of citizen. What is the responsibility of the citizens? Let's study. The first point is voting in election. Participation is an important element in the working of democratic and government. Voting is an important component of democracy. Voting is a great power of citizen. Thus, it is a major responsibility of citizen to participate in an election. One should always vote for the right candidate. Second, paying taxes. Taxes are the price we pay for the civilized society, money provided. Next, by taxation is used by the government by bringing government development activities. These activities can include education system, health system, pension for the elderly, unemployment benefits, and power public transportation. The last point is awareness. In a democratic country, government is responsible for the welfare of people. It is the responsibility of the people to check all the decisions taken by the government. People can criticize the decision of government in case it is arbitrary nature. So student, as I have completed with the chapter, if you have any doubt, do a comment on a Facebook or YouTube. Thank you.